الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على أهل بيت نبيك وأحبته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبط نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن أظلم ممن منع مساجد الله أن يذكر فيها اسمه وسعى في خرابها أولئك ما كان لهم أن يدخلوها إلا خائفين لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم صدق الله العلي العظيم
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
The month of Ramadan was the month of the Holy Quran, the month that witnessed the descension and the birth of the Holy Quran, and the month where the mosques were overcrowded with worshippers. But the same month, the same last month of Ramadan, witnessed the highest number of the destructions of mosques and masajid during the month of Ramadan. Masajid were attacked, worshippers who were worshipping and fasting, praying and fasting, were killed and bombed in Kuwait, in the eastern province of the Arabian Peninsula. In Yemen, many masajid were bombed and destroyed during the days and the nights of Ramadan, in Aden, in Sana'a, in many other places. Mosques in Iraq were destroyed during the month of Ramadan. Mosques in Syria were destroyed. And these masajid and mosques were destroyed by one source, one money, one hand, one strategy from one sponsor, from one country that sponsors terrorism against its opponents, against other madahib. All these names, ISIS, Al-Qaeda, Boko Haram, Al-Shabaab, Lashkar, Sahaba, this or that in Pakistan, in Somalia, in East Africa, in Syria, in Iraq, in Algeria, in Tunisia, in Egypt, in Yemen, they stem from one source of evil, one source of deviation, one source of corruption that comes from one budget and one hand and one organizer who's sitting in the middle of the Arabian Peninsula and is planning to destroy the Muslim Ummah and instill tension among the Muslim Ummah. This same hand that destroyed masajid in the past Ramadan in many countries also was responsible for destroying the Baqee 88 years. The dome and the minaret and the shrine of Baqee was destroyed on April 21st, 1927, by the same family, by the same money, with the same mentality, the mentality of hate and grudge against the Prophet and his family 88 years ago, with the same goal and same objective, to keep people away from the truth, to keep people away from understanding who is the legitimate caliph and successor to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To keep distance between people and Ahlul Bayt. When people are away from Ahlul Bayt, they are completely lost. Completely lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I leave two weighty things. Kitab Allah wa itrati Ahlul Bayt. If you seek guidance, if you seek truth, if you seek dignity, the reason why many Muslims today, the vast majorities of Muslims are undignified. Undignified. A small enemy, small country can defeat all Muslim countries. The reason? Because they are not following Kitab Allah wa Itrati Ahlul Bayt. They are led by corrupt scholars who work for the Sultan, who work for the dunya, not for the akhirah. This is a nutshell. If you want to know why Muslims are backward, why Muslims are killing each other, this is the reason. Because their ulama, their scholars, especially in that particular country, they follow the political establishment. They get paid by the political establishment. Therefore, they don't speak the truth. يَكْتُمُونَ مَا أَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَةِ. They are coward and they don't speak the truth. And so the same hand that destroyed, the same source, the same mentality and ideology that destroyed the masajid in Ramadan in Kuwait and Yemen and Syria and Iraq and Hijaz, destroyed the Baqee in Medina and Jannatul Mu'alla in Mecca, Hujun, Maqbaratul Hujun, 88 years ago. On the basis that these are places of shirk. It's not places of shirk. If these are places of shirk, then the same argument should go for the grave of the Prophet in Medina. But they are not places of worship, shirk. They are places of worship and tawheed. And this is found in Surah Al-Kahf. قَالَ الَّذِينَ غَلَبُوا عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِمْ لَنَتَّخِذَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ مَسْجِدًا. Small group of people who were not anbiya, not the prophets, not imams, simply they were good people. Good, religious, righteous people, six or seven or eight, according to the Quran. When they died, the good people said, لَنَتَّخِذَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ مَسْجِدًا. We will erect a place of worship, masjid here, so people come and look at their graves, and they remember their sacrifice. So they go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They get close to Allah. This is in Surah Al-Kahf. So Allah says, it's okay if there is a grave of someone who's wali, imam, to build a masjid. People are not worshipping him. No. People worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. If we are standing before this mihrab now, here, let me ask you, this mihrab, are we worshipping the mihrab? If someone comes from outside, he says, wow, look at people here are worshipping the mihrab, standing before mihrab. He goes to the church and he finds Christians standing before the statue of Jesus. They worship Jesus. He comes to the mosque and he looks at the mihrab, the sanctuary, and he says, wow, look at people worshipping mihrab. Are we worshipping mihrab? What is the answer? The answer is we are not worshipping mihrab or sanctuary. We are worshipping Allah. But Allah says, take one direction to me. I am in all directions. Wherever, even if we face today, even if we face that direction, it goes to Allah. But Allah says, as a symbol of unity, coherence, togetherness, face this direction to Mecca. So we are not worshipping Allah. The same thing when you go to a cemetery, to Maqabir, you are not worshipping them. You are not worshipping the dead ones. We are worshipping only Allah. I repeat this every single day. We worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These cemeteries that buries contains the prophets and imams, they remind us that one day we have to go to the akhirah. It gets us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not worshipping min dunillah. No, it's not. Allahumma akhbar al-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat wal-muslimin wal-muslimat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات، إنك مجيب الدعوات، إنك غافر الخطيئات، إنك ماحي السيئات وجاعلها حسنات. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين على الخير والبر والصلاح والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين، ومن على مرضانا بالشفاء والعافية، وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان، وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات والشهداء ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.